We will now go over study problem 6-2 from our textbook. We are given a company, Kaifu Corporation, and the market. Market can be the New York Stock Exchange or the Dow Jones Industrial Average, any index representing the overall performance of the market. And we are to find the average return and standard deviation for both this company and the market. Obviously, we are provided with some historical data over the last 4 months for both our company and for the market. Therefore, we will be using the historical approach, not the scenario analysis that we have solved problem study problem 6-1. So in the historical approach, average return is quite easy to figure. All we do is to take arithmetic mean of the four past returns. So basically, the expected return for our company Kaifu is equal to 4 plus 6 plus 0 plus 2, everything in percent, all divided by 4, because as I said, we have historical data related to the last 4 months. And as a result, we would get 12 over 4, 12% over 4, which gives us a 3% monthly return for our investment. Well, monthly return for Kaifu Corporation. In a similar way, we can calculate the expected return for the market. Will be not much different here. So we will have 2 plus 3 plus 1 plus negative 1%, all divided by 4. Obviously, plus 1 and minus 1 will cancel each other out. 5% divided by 4, and that should be a 1.25% market return. Now we are done with the first parts. Now in the second part, we need the standard deviations. So that part is a little bit more involved. I want to make sure that I can use the space given in, so I will just create two additional columns, one right to the right side of Kaifu and one to the right side of the market. So this way it will, I will be able to use my space more effectively. So when I'm about to figure out the standard deviation for Kaifu, all I need is the squared deviation of the monthly returns from the expected return. So therefore, all I will have here for the first row, I will get 4% return minus, let me just remove the percent signs and I will come back to it at the end. 4 minus 3 squared here, it would be 6 minus 3 squared. Why 3? Because that's our average return here. 0 minus 3 squared here, and finally 2 minus 3 squared. And these numbers would need to add up, so we need to add up these numbers. Let me just create some little bit space underneath. So now going back to our calculation here, so our variance in this case, the variance first for Kaifu obviously would be equal to this long sum, 4 minus 3 squared. Actually, let me just go ahead and write down the result of the calculation here. So 4 minus 3 squared would be 1. So we have 1 squared plus 3, 6 minus 3 is 3, 3 squared plus 0 minus 3 is negative 3, negative 3 squared, plus negative 1 squared, all divided by, so now this one we need to be careful. We said we have 4 data about the last 4 months, but in the case of the historical approach, the variance, for the variance or for the standard deviation, the number of periods should be minus 1 because we have a sample here. So sample standard deviation or sample variance would have to have this minus 1 here. Okay, so from that we get that 1 plus 9 plus 9 plus another 1, all divided by 3, that's basically 20%, 20 over 3. So let me, okay, so let's just write it like this. So 6.67 percent, because we just squared the percent, so percent squared, let's say. And for the standard deviation, obviously, it would be the square root of that. So this implies the standard deviation would be actually equal to 2.58%. 2.58% for Kaifu. In a similar way, let me use another color here. We can do the same thing for the market. We have 2 minus the market return was 1.25 squared. Here it would be 3 minus 1.25 squared. And then we have 1 minus 1.25 squared. And finally, minus 1 minus 1.25 squared. So we have the variance for the market. Again, divide everything divided by 4 minus 1. So 2 minus 1.25 would be 0.75 squared. 0.75 squared. 3 minus 1.25 would be 1.75 plus 1.75 squared. 1 minus 1.25 would be minus 0.25 squared plus minus 0.25 squared. And finally, minus 1 minus 1.25 would give you minus 2.25, everything squared. So that would... So I just leave it to you to figure out what is the total here. And ultimately, when you calculate the standard deviation, I did it myself, so make sure you do it as well. You basically take the square root of this final result, and the square root of everything should give you 1.71%. So we are done with the second part of the problem as well. So for the individual investment, Kaifu Corporation, 3% is the expected monthly return, 2.58% is the standard deviation. We don't have to annualize anything here. And for market return, monthly market return is 1.25%, whereas the standard deviation for the market is 1.71%. And again, we don't have to annualize. But just as a side note, if in the case of annualizing the expected return is very straightforward. You just multiply your result by 12. That's only an approximation, obviously. If you want to be more accurate, you need to use the features of our financial calculator regarding the present and future value calculations. For the standard deviation, things are a little bit different. To annualize a monthly standard deviation, instead of multiplying by 12, you multiply it by square root 12. Why? Because to annualize the variance, you multiply it by 12. Then when you convert it back to standard deviation, you take the square root, and that's why we are multiplying by square root 12. But as I said, the question does not particularly specify about the expected return or the standard deviation to be annualized, so we will not annualize those. We'll just leave them as they are. And that would pretty much complete the solution for our problem. Another side note is that comparing these two investments, which one is superior? Well, when we compare the expected returns, it looks like our individual investment in this individual firm, Kaifu, outperforms the market. However, when we look at risk, it turns out that the market is less risky than the individual firm. So in that sense, it's not obvious. So none of these investments in this individual firm versus the market dominates the other. So one is better in terms of return, in that case the company, and in terms of risk, investing in the market index is a better choice. As I said, that solves our problem and we are done.